We talked about the idea of finding the sample mean, one of the measurements of location, and now I want to talk about the idea of finding the sample median, another measurement of location. Now, in English, we will of course say it's the median. The parameter is a Greek letter theta, which is a circle with a horizontal line through it, like that. The statistic is M, and it measures the physical center of a population or a data set or a sample data set. Now, the median is the physical center of the data. And you need at least ordinal data. In reality, the median for ordinal data really doesn't make a lot of sense. I mean, it kind of does, but to me it's very awkward, and I usually stick to using the median for interval or racial. I mean, technically you can do it for the median, but it just feels very awkward. Let's get into calculating the median real quick. So suppose we have these data values, 47, 1, and 4. If I'm going to find the median, the first thing I need to do is sort the data. Does it make any sense to say this one's in the center if the data is not sorted? So when I sort the data, the smallest to from smallest to biggest got 1, 45, and 47. So the median is the middle value of 45. So what we say is that M, I'm assuming this is sample data, M equals 45. Now I notice there are three numbers here. That's an odd number of values. If there's an even number of data values, such as like 1, 45, 44, and 47, then once again, we still have to sort the data. But now that we've sorted it, we're going to take these middle two values right here, and we're going to find the average. So the average of 44 plus 45 over 2, this is how you find the average, add them up and divide by 2. This is going to be 44.5. So this is the value that we would identify as the sample median. Now notice in this first one, let's put this on our number line real quick. Say 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So here are our data values. We had a 1, a 45, and a 47. Now the median was the middle guy, 45. See, this is by no means a balancing point. The average would be like in here someplace. If we add all these numbers up together and then divide it by 3, we get an average down here someplace. The median is simply the guy physically in the center, period. The median does not balance it out numerically as such. Now, it will balance it out in terms of the number of values, because the median being physically in the middle, when we get to this in a little while, one of the definitions, the way to look at it, is a value such that no more than 50% of the values are, of all the data values are below, and no more than 50% of all the data values are above. So it does balance it in that sense, as in terms of the number of data values above and below, but numerically, it is not a balancing point. You see here for this second example where we added the value 47 to it. No, we added a value of 44, I'm sorry. We added 44 to it. Well, 44 would be down here. And then we took the average, so right in between, there's the median at 44.5. See, half the values, 2, are above, half the values, 2, are below. So it's balancing it in terms of the number of observations above and below, but not in terms of the numerical values. Now, notice for both the mean and the median, there's absolutely no requirement that the value you identify is a member of the data set. Most commonly, it won't be. Sometimes it will, but most commonly, it won't be. If you have an odd number of values, then the median will always be a member of your data set. If you have an even number, then it may or may not be. Or probably not, but it could be. Let's just say, for example, our data set consisted of 1, 45, 45, 47. you'll see the two guys in the middle are 45. The average of 45 and 45 is 45. So the median would be 45. So in this case, because of the repeated values, even though they're even number, I did get a value for the median that is actually a member of the data set. But there's no reason to expect this is going to happen every time you find the median. So let's just take a moment here and make a decision in terms of, or talk about how to decide which to use. What's better, the mean or the median? Well, there probably is no specific answer to which is better. It's really more like what is better for the scenario that you're currently working for or working with. And as a general rule, to identify the single best measurement, we look at the shape of the distribution. If the distribution is bell-shaped or is symmetric, then we typically use the mean. In reality, if it's symmetric, the mean and the median will be the same. In the population, they'll be the same. Because in a sample, you never really truly get truly symmetric data. You could, but it's very, very rare. So the mean and the median, the values will be very closely together if the distribution is approximately symmetric. If it's non-symmetric, then we typically use the median. And the reason for that is really pretty simple. Let's take a look at some data values, some real simple example. How about 1, 2, and 3? So in this case, what is the mean? X bar, well, that's 2. What is the median? M, well, that's also 2. Suppose now I used 1, 2, and say 6. Well, what is X bar? Well, I have 6 and 3 is 9 divided by 3. That's 3. What's the median? Well, the guy in the middle is still 2. Notice that 1, 2, and 3 is very symmetric. The mean and the median are exactly the same. 1, 2, and 6 is not symmetric. 1 and 2 are close to each other. There's a big gap before you get to 6. So what happens? The mean gets pulled toward this tail. If you put this on a number line, the first data set, 1, 2, 3, very symmetric. The mean and the median is right here at 2. The second one, 1, 2, and 6, the mean gets pulled in this direction. With more data of this that looks like this, you would see that this distribution is skewed right. So the data is skewed, the mean gets pulled into the, or in the direction of the tail. Now suppose the data consists of 1, 2, and how about, 27. Well, X bar equals 27, 2, and 1 is 30, divided by 3 is 10, so the average is 10, and the median is 2. So the median just set there. It's not moving. I can change this value. This is actually create an extreme outlier, and the median's not going to move, but the mean will keep getting pulled further and further away from the bulk of the data down here at 1 and 2. We say that the median is invariant to outliers. That means invariant simply means it doesn't vary, it doesn't change. You have an outlier, and that's what we're getting here. It is values far away from the bulk of what else is going on, and that has no effect on the median. The mean, on the other hand, is very sensitive to outliers. Hence the reason, if it's non-symmetric, if we take a look at the shape, it's not symmetric. That's why we typically want to use the median, because if it's non-symmetric, like heavily skewed right, we have outliers that's pulling the mean, but the median is very, very stable. If it's symmetric, then the mean and the median are the same. So we typically want to use the mean. It's much easier to work with, and everybody understands what an average is.